Constipation in adults is common, typically defined by less than 3 bowel motions per week, and can be caused by both benign and serious conditions. We organize our approach to chronic constipation by differentiating patients with primary or functional constipation and those with secondary causes. Here are 3 causes of constipation in adults you need to know about. Primary constipation can be from normal or slowed colonic transit, or primary defecation disorders. Patients with normal transit constipation pass hard stools, but have normal colonic motility. This is often seen in the setting of poor fiber and fluid intake or stress. In contrast, patients with slow transit constipation have prolonged colonic transit time from reduced colonic intrinsic nerve activity. They often do not feel the urge to defecate despite very infrequent bowel motions. Finally, primary constipation can result from defecatory disorder such as anorectal dysenergia. This is caused by incoordination of the pelvic floor muscles, often from poor toileting habits. These patients complain of significant straining and may respond to biofeedback. Secondary constipation can be related to structural obstructions to stool transit. The most worrisome cause is colorectal cancer, which develops in up to 1 in 14 men and 1 in 16 women. Patients with a family history of colon cancer or inflammatory bowel disease are at particularly high risk. Patients over 50 with iron deficiency anemia or acute change in bowel habits need endoscopic evaluation to rule out colon cancer. Many medications cause chronic constipation. The most common drug cause is from opioids that slow colonic transit. Other common culprits include anticholinergics, antihistamines, antipsychotics, tricyclic antidepressants, and antihypertensive medications. Weaning or discontinuing potentially implicated drugs should be tried. If the patient cannot stop regularly prescribed medications, initial treatment with stool softeners, osmotic laxatives, and as-needed rectal therapy with suppositories or enemas can be helpful.